You know, even in my attempts of adding levity to this list, the three films I added all still involve death, like premature death. I find that interesting. To Fault in Our Stars, as well as the next two films, came out the summer before my sophomore year of high school. I remember at its release, my mom wanted to see it too, because I had gushed about the book to her. We came out of the theater both loving it. When it came out on DVD, she bought it for herself, but it went in my movie drawer because mine is bigger. Now, past 16, I didn't really watch it that much, and neither did my mom. Honestly, I forgot I owned it until I moved, but I never gave it away because I remember she liked it. Now, I will admit, the connection here is mainly cancer, and the surface fact that she liked it. And while watching it, I couldn't pull any other reason she might have liked it outside of its acute and tragic love story. But it is still here because, boy oh boy, did this movie make me feel things. Brief summary, for those who have never seen it, is about Hazel and Gus, two teens who are suffering from cancer. Hazel has a cancer that affects her lungs and is ongoing, and Gus had one that resulted in his leg needing to be cut off, and is, at the start of the film, in remission. The two fall in love, and it ends with his death and funeral. I took like a page and a half of notes about my feelings, so I'm just gonna talk about them. The film reminded me of what my mom having cancer was like. There were a lot of happy days, and they made it easy for me to subconsciously pretend it wasn't happening. But then there were days when she'd be tired or felt weak. Even still, though, on those days, she'd push through it. She'd say that she was fine. During the year and a half she was sick, we still went to movies, we'd still go out to eat, and go to family gatherings. And she'd still go to chapter meetings and sorority events. And like Gus, she got the cancer-affected area cut off. But also, like Gus, a scan lit up like a Christmas tree, and now the cancer was in her lungs and liver. Still though, she was so strong, I thought it was all going to be okay. Then that last month came, and out of seemingly nowhere, she was sick. She'd be throwing up, she couldn't drive herself, and she had to be wheeled around in a wheelchair because she was too weak to walk. Now, something fully positive this film did make me think about was the idea of the last good day. Now, it's exactly what it sounds like. It's the last good day someone has before they die. On the day you don't know it's the last good day, you just see it as another good day. For Gus, it was the day he held his mock funeral, where Hazel and their mutual friend Isaac gave Gus their eulogies. Interesting last good day, but it made him happy, and that's all that matters. Now, what I consider my mom's last good day was when we went to go see Endgame. It was the last movie we saw together, and in terms of goodness, she wasn't as weak that day. In fact, she was able to drive us to the theater. She was awake for the first half, and seeing as it was a 3-hour movie, that's pretty good. And that smile she gave me during the big fight, I'll never forget it. This film and its depiction of a sick person and their life is definitely one shown through rose-colored glasses. It's romantic and warm. In fact, the only thing that gives it a touch of realism is the last 20 minutes, where they were showing how sick Gus was. I enjoyed watching it, though, and naturally, it made me miss my mom.